Welcome back to Salesforce Associate Exam Reports and Dashboards. I'm the Dark Knight Edmund. Let's get this started. In this section of the test, it's all about reports and dashboard. It makes up 15% of the test. Basically, you have to describe what reports are and also describe what dashboards and Salesforce are. Pretty straightforward examples in the org there. The first thing we're going to talk about is a report. So what is in a report? When you build a report out, you have to identify a couple of things. So the type, so what object or objects are you looking at? The time frame, so from when and where do you want to look at these records from? What data do you want to see? So what are the actual data points you want to capture on the report? The format, so are we going to build a tabular report, are we going to build a summary report, are we going to be a matrix or a joined? Every report, it has to be one of those. What data do you want your totals for? So if there's any of those metrics in there you want totals for, make sure you put them on the page. What are the records you want? So when we build our report, we can add some filters. So we may want to filter additional things as well. And then visuals. Do you want to add any visuals to your report? It's not a requirement, but it's always helpful to have a visual representation of your report. All right, before we get into actually building reports, let's talk about report types. Report types are the identification of finding what report you want. So this is the reporting tool. This is what you're going to select based on the most relevant object that you want to pull data from. So it could be accounts, could be contacts, could be your custom object, whatever you want to build reports from. You can build a report from a report type. So report type has those predefined characteristics of those objects and the relationships, and then it just brings them into a report builder for you. When you want to build a report and you don't have a report type that matches, you can always create your own custom report. You can create a custom report type. This is basically when those standard report types that Salesforce provides you don't do what you need them to do, you can come in here and build your own report type. Right, so you can build your own report type by going back into setup here. And then in the quick find here, just type in report. Go to report types. And then from here, you can create a new custom report type. And then you can first select your primary object, we'll go with account, and then we can say account event with no event. We have account with no events, gives a name, we give it a description, let's that have no event. Then we can put in a category, put in that one, and it can either be in development or deployed. In development, only admins can see this, deployments, everyone can see this. We'll leave it in deployment because we don't need to push it to everyone else. From here, we have our object. So we have a primary object of account. We can select related objects. I'm going to select the event. And then if we wanted to, we actually add additional objects in there if we wanted to, so we could pick on there as well. So depending on what we have here, we can say the relationship is either they have to be associated or they may not be associated. So see in the Venn diagram here, when they have to be related, it gives us a small sample here. Say which ones aren't related. I can say get all my accounts and also give me the accounts that have events tied to them. So a nice little thing we can do there. From here, we can also then see what that looks like, and then we can also look at the layout of the different fields that are being selected. It's grabbing all the fields by default, and we can move things around here if we want. We can add different page previews if we want, so we can just see how this would look in when we actually build the report. All right, let's talk about report filters. So one of those things I was talking about, when we need to set up a report, we have to put filters in there. There's a lot of different filters in the system. We have our standard filters here of the show me and the create time. So this is going to show me the ownership of a record. This is going to show you a time frame that you can select from. Then we can also add an additional filters like last name or mailing state. We add additional filters of that. And then we also then modify that filter logic for those. You can also add cross filters. This allows you to basically eliminate data from the report to only show data that matches that your cross filter that you're applying, so that you can utilize other objects that aren't in the actual report type that you're utilizing, as long as there's a relationship between the two. So back at our home here, let's go to our report tab. Go to reports. This is what the default reports looks like. We have all the reports. There's nothing in here because I haven't viewed any of it as yet. I can see all my public and private reports that are in the system, so there's a lot that are in here. To create a new one, just click on the new report here, and then we're at a, here we are again at a select a report type. I can select any report types that are available to me. These are my recently used. I want to see all of them. I click on that all, and then so forth and so forth. We'll go with accounts. Click start report, and then it's going to show us our basic report here. Nothing's running. If we want to see the actual results, we can turn on update preview. Nothing still is being shown because our filters are hiding data that. All right, so here on our Blink account report, we can click over into our filters section here. These are, you can see we're not seeing anything right now because nothing is being shown. If I click they show me, say all accounts, nothing still shows because I haven't created any records since May 18th. Come in here and change this custom to all time and click apply. Now I see a bunch of the different records in there. From here, I can also add some additional filters. Let's say I can go off of billing. Let's say is equal to blank and hit apply. And that's going to give me all my state, all my records where the state is blank. And then I can also add another filter type of here of type. And we say where it's equal to no selection. Now I have a report now where the billing state is province and the type is blank, and it just tells me where all the blanks are on my report here, so I can build a report. From here, I could also then, if I really wanted to, add some filter logic. So the two right here, the billing state and the type, I can say and or, so I can do or, just by typing the word or in here. And it's going to show me any of the states where the state is blank and the type is blank as well. So you can see in this one here, the widget corpus here, the state has California in there. The type is blank, so it's being populated in this particular report. All right, so that's filters. Cross filter is how we can reference another object and apply that logic to this particular report. So I can say, show me accounts with or without cases. So I'm going to say, show me all my accounts that don't have cases, or I can say, show me all the accounts that have cases. So I'm going to say, show accounts that have cases. And you notice that my list gets dramatically smaller because I only have a couple cases in my org here that are tied to accounts. Click run, and then this would be my report where where we have accounts that have cases tied to them, where the billing or type field is blank. So that is report and report filters in a nutshell. One of the other things I want to point out, the report filters that show me, again, I just want to walk through that again. These are the different kinds of filters that we are running as a user. So the report is my account. Whoever is running that report will see their account. So if I, Jake, makes the report, and then when I run it, I will also see that. But if Sue runs a report, it's going to show what Sue can see. So depending on your selection there, when it says my, it's going to be run as whoever has visibility to those records. So my accounts could be different than another person's my accounts. It's going to show the records that they own versus the records that I own. So just a little cool little thing that you can do to make a report more dynamic for your individual users. So here are report columns. We can add or remove columns that are relevant to your report. Just as a reminder, always put only the most relevant columns and fields in your report. Don't add extras in there because it's only going to make your report take longer to run. All right, so we're on a report builder again here. We have all these different report types in here. Since we're not in this report here, since we're not looking at rating, I can go over here and click off rating, just remove it and remove it from my report. Remove last modified date, remove that from there as well. If I wanted to add fields, I can go here and click and add any fields I want. I can add account site if I wanted. You want to see all the fields that are in your report type, you can expand this here and you can see all the different ones that are available to you. All right, let's talk about tabular reports. Tabular reports are just a list. There's no groupings. These can only make lists on charts, more or less. So the report that we're actually looking for is technically a tabular report. There are no groupings. We haven't grouped anything. You can see it's blank here. If I were to go over here and add charts, I can't add any charts right now because it doesn't have any. If I click run, still no charts or anything like that. So I can just come in here and see the actual chart there. That is a tabular report. The next type of report is a summary report. This is where we have a grouping on a row. This does allow most of your charts because you're now going to be grouping on things. Go ahead to a report builder here, add a group, do account owner because why not? You can see that I own most of these accounts. You can see that the last activity and all that are populating. I'm being grouped by them. But if I wanted to, I could, instead of going by owner, I could go by billing. Billing state province here. And we can see that we have two that don't have any identified. We have, and then we have one that's in these other states as well. So that is a summary report. So this is a summary report here. We have all our different reports that are available to us. Like I said, this has one grouping in it, which makes it a summary report. The next type of report is a matrix report. This is just a grouping on row and column. This also offers most of your charts that are available out there for you as well. So if you hop on over to the report builder and we click edit and we add additional groupings here, we can add a grouping here and we can actually go by owner now. And we're going to say that we can see that of all the records that are in the different states, I own all of them because that's how we filtered that report. This is a summary report. We can add a chart again here and we just see what it looks like that. All right, the last type of report is a joined report. This is the mashup of two different report types that filter in the same field. So in this scenario, I have accounts and cases, and we're building a joined report based off of the account. So it's going to show me all my account blocks and it's going to show me all my cases for that particular account. That's how that works for that joined report. Joined reports don't get used very often, but when they do, they get used to show correlating data that maybe you don't have in a set. Maybe you want to see accounts with opportunities and accounts with cases all in one report. You couldn't do that in a report type, but you can do that with a joined report. Now let's talk about dashboards. So dashboards, this is how you can build graphical representations of all your different reports that you generate. You can put them all on a single dashboard, and then you can run that dashboard to see all the graphical representations of that report or different variations of that report. To build a report, to build a dashboard, it's pretty simple. Hop on over to the dashboards tab there. Save that. So on the dashboards tab here, we have all our different reads, and you can see all the ones that we have that are available. To create a new dashboard, you click new dashboard. Give it a name. And then from here, you click component, you select the report. I can select the report that I just created here and put it in here. And I can select one of my charts. These are different charts that are going to be available to us. You can click through them and see what the different ones they do, what the hell they look. And then once you add that there, like I said, it's just going to show a graphical representation of your report. You can click component again. I should take the same one there if I want to select a different report type. Let's go with this one. Let's go with this one. Or this one. Yeah, there we go, that one. And then you can see that we have them on here. I can change the size of them if I want. So you can keep adding those in there, and then you click done when you're done with it. And then you can have your different dashboards with all your different reports in there. So like I said, it's just a graphical representation. Show what your reports are on a single thing. You can have multiple reports on your page here as well, dashboard components on your page as well. As you just saw, you saw me add a component. So adding a chart, first you select your report and add the chart component. So we selected that report type, we added the chart. And if we want to, we can modify the X and Y axis depending on the report type. If it was a matrix, we could modify them. If it's just a summary, it's just going to be your grouping. You can make your dashboard dynamic by changing the who you want the user to be, the dashboard be ran as. If you select the dashboard viewer, then it'll always be the person who ran the dashboard, and it only can be what they can see. So I can build a dashboard and say I'm going to be the runner. So when everybody sees that dashboard, they can see what I can see. But if I change the dashboard viewer, it's going to be ran as a dashboard viewer. So if they open up a dashboard and they have no access to any records, then I can see anything on that dashboard. Within a dashboard, you can also build filters. This only works on like reports that are shared, that share the same field. So if you're going to build a dashboard and it has all accounts and then you want to filter like on a state, you can do something like that. But if you're going to filter, you're going to build a dashboard and you want to filter on something and all the reports don't share that type of value, the filter is not going to work on all the reports on that particular page. All right. Hope you learned something today. Come back again for future trainings. Hopefully you're coming back for the admin sessions. Like I said, this is the Salesforce Associate final deep dive of reports and dashboards. If you like this content, please like, subscribe, and come back later. All right. Thanks again, and I'll see you next time.